first and 10. Wants it all. Deep over the middle for Winicky. Has it inside the 10. Still with it. Diana Powerball. Ilfil Velez on the run. Diving in the alley.
It's Alexander with a nice move. Goes to the rim. Got it to go.
Hi, friends, and welcome to this week's Jackrabbit Insider. I'm Tyler Merriam. It is great to have you with us. Ahead on the show, we'll take a look back at the tremendous catches that the Jackrabbit receiving corps has put together in 2016. They've already made a pair of appearances in SportsCenter Top Plays. One of those was from Connor Landberg. He's our senior student athlete spotlight. And we'll have Coach John Stiglmeyer in studio to recap last night's contest on the road at Southern Illinois. But there is a lot of excitement about the men's basketball program as the Jacks are picked second in this week's Summit League preseason poll. And the excitement extends to practice. A new head coach, TJ Otzelberger.
Being a great community, great people, people are supportive is awesome. And then you come here and work every day, it's a dream come true. We have a chance to work with great players, great people, guys who want to get better, a culture that wants to win. And for me, this is everything I could ever want in a situation for myself and my family, but also professionally, absolute dream come true.
Otzelberger says his first priority after becoming head coach was to build trust with the returning Jacks.
I wanted to make sure that I really spent time with them, that I really invested in each of them individually, got to learn about them, learn about their families, what brought them here. Why do they have such a great sense of pride for Jackrabbit basketball? And you make that investment, and you spend that time with the players, you see how important, you see how special this place is. You build those relationships. And then from there, what we need to do is evaluate the strengths of our basketball team and who are some other players we might be able to bring in to help complement this group.
One of those is 6'7" A.J. Hess, an Arizona native and graduate transfer from Southern Utah, where he started 63 games in three seasons, shooting better than 40% from deep.
Yeah, A.J. Hess, from day one that he's gotten here, he's really taken a major step. He played primarily at the four position at Southern Utah. We've asked him to play on the perimeter as a guard. He stepped up. He's embraced the challenge. He's really worked on his body, getting in great shape. Unbelievable shooter, unbelievable character, guys. He's going to be a guy who's going to be one of the better players in this conference, not only on our team, but in this conference.
Milwaukee native Chris Howell is another transfer expected to make an immediate impact. The 6'5 sophomore guard averaged 12 points and 7 rebounds at Butler Community College 2 years ago, but missed all of last season with an injury.
Unbelievable energy guy, versatile, plays a lot of different positions. Unique game, he can get to the basket, make plays for people, be a lockdown defender. Those two guys have been phenomenal. We've also got Michael Orris comes in, gives another point guard, guy who's got leadership skills, guy who can step in and run a team, who's got experience from places he's been.
Something new this year is the squad has two designated captains. One is 6'7 junior guard Reed Tellinghuisen, who has buried 118 threes in his first 2 years. The other is sophomore post Mike Dom. The 6'9 Nebraskan was a freshman All-American last year, averaging 15 points and 6 rebounds, while establishing a new program record for points by a freshman.
They've been unbelievable leaders for our team. They've been tremendous on a daily basis, extreme, not only bought in to what they need to do, but bought in from a leadership standpoint. They bought in from day one. They've had my back. I hope they feel that I've had theirs. They've been tremendous. So regardless of what happens on the basketball court, it starts with the team commitment, the unity. Those guys embody that.
There's only been a handful of practices thus far, but Otzelberger likes what he's seen.
The effort is what we've really tried to emphasize. Bringing an elite effort every day to practice, a commitment to trying to do everything we're asking our guys to do, be their best when we need them to be their best. And I feel like we haven't taken a drill for granted. I feel like we haven't taken a possession for granted. I feel like our guys have a championship mentality, understand that everything we do out here needs to be with maximum effort, and really excited that they brought that this first week of practice.
And don't forget the Jackrabbit basketball tip-off. The big event to begin the season will be Thursday night inside Frost Arena. A lot more to come this week on The Insider. John Stiglmeyer is in studio after we go inside state.
There's something in Hobo Week for everybody. I competed in Cavorts, the talent show. It was just something we were gonna do for fun, and we ended up winning, so that was really sweet. My name is Hope Yager, and I'm from Watertown, South Dakota. SDSU is cool because it's so community-based. Even though there's 12,000 plus students, I can always walk through the union and know someone. I think it's really cool, all the different types of friends you get to meet. We do homework together. We sing together a lot. We just do random things. We go to Qdoba. We go there probably 3 times a week. That's accurate. I go there a lot. On Halloween, we actually have this thing called Rocktoberfest, and it's where we all like dress up and we have like a dance party and stuff, and it's just really fun. My major here is music education, and I specialize in vocal. I want to be maybe an elementary choir director. I like kids a lot, and high school students too, but kids are kind of more geared towards me, I think. I'm really involved with Oasis through the Wesleyan Church here. Also, I'm in concert choir, so that's pretty much like a sport, and that's where I met like most of my friends. I've met a lot of people that are kind of nervous to come to this university just because it's so big and like they don't know how they're gonna fit in, but I would really just give the advice to try everything and anything. Thanks to SDSU, I'm ready to make what I love doing into a career.
Listen up. This is the time, this is the place, and this is Ford F-150, the truck that goes toe-to-toe with your life. Made of high-strength, military-grade aluminum alloy, it pulled the highest safety rating the government can give. And with Pro Trailer Backup Assist, it's like having your head on a swivel, pal. So load up your crew. This is the time.
Now get up to $10,395 in total savings or lease an F-150 for just $279 a month. Visit your local Northland Ford dealer today.
How did we become the region's largest independent seed company? By taking a very simple but powerful stand. We will sell no seed that we wouldn't be happy to plant on our own farm. Peterson Farm Seed. Stand tall.
Being part of a great team means you know your role and you work your role to the best of your ability. If you're consistently going to show up and be your best, you're going to be part of that team. You can see the success they have over time. It's not just 1 year flash in the pan. It's consistent success over time, which makes them great. And that's where the work ethic comes in. The ability to come into work, do the same thing repeatedly, day after day after day, and putting your best foot forward is going to separate you from the rest.
Choose the experts. Choose Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine.
This portion of the Jackrabbit Insider is brought to you by Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine. Expert care when you need it.
Welcome back to the Insider. Time to talk football with head coach John Stiglmeyer. Jacks on the road at Southern Illinois Saturday night. This was an offensive explosion. 1,092 yards, 12 plays of 20 or more yards, and 11 touchdowns between the two teams. Yeah, being a defensive-minded guy, I have a feeling you weren't too pleased at times.
You know, you're exactly right, all right? But let's expand on it. People call that a shootout. They shouldn't say that in football. We shouldn't be part of that in football, at least on the defensive side. I thought SIU had a really good game plan, and we had trouble slowing them down. We obviously had a great game plan, but the Jacks won, and that's what we needed to do.
And let's have a look at how the Jacks won on Saturday night.
Really was a beautiful night in Carbondale, and SDSU jumped ahead early on the opening drive. Dallas Goddard in the end around his first career carry, and the tight end goes 17 yards for a touchdown at 7-0. Game is tied at 7 later in the first quarter. Jake Winicky on the receiving end of this 47-yard bomb from Taryn Christian. Jacks led it 14-7 at the end of the first period. Less than 3 minutes left in the second quarter. It's Goddard on the receiving end of the Christian dart, and he takes it 39 yards. 21-7 SDSU. Jacks tack on another score just before halftime. Christian to Winicky, this time a 17-yarder. SDSU led 28-18 at the break. Early in the third quarter, Brady Mengarelli catches the swing pass, and he takes it 56 yards. South Dakota State led 35-18 at that moment. Southern Illinois cut it to 35-32 when Christian connects with Alex Wilde for his fifth touchdown pass of the night, a 27-yarder. Jacks Jacks led 42-32 at the moment and hang on for a 45-39 victory.
We talked about it being an offensive shootout. All those highlights are offensive in nature, we just showed, and yet your defense down the stretch is what won you this game. You had 6 sacks as a team. That's the most for your program since the Northern Arizona playoff game 3 years ago. But 3 of the final 8 plays SIU ran, including its final one, you came up with a sack, and again, that's what clinched the game.
Well, it did, and our guys rose up, and it wasn't like those guys were loafing in the football game. I mean, it was a battle. They had a ton of plays, so that tires your defensive, the whole defensive program down, the players down, and I was really happy to see those guys rise up at the end and make these plays.
Quarterback Tyrann Christian established a new single-game program record for passing yards, 466. He threw for 5 touchdowns. He was 32 of 51. Am I crazy to think, though, he was off at times in this game? He wasn't perfect, and he still threw for 466.
Well, he had, now again, let's give credit to the fat guys. He had some good time many times. Yes, he overthrew some balls a number of times. But again, a lot of yards, a lot of plays. You got some good targets.
I'd love to throw for 466 and it not be my best game. One of those good targets, Dallas Goedert, 12 catches, one of only 6 times ever a player has had 12 catches in Jackrabbit football lore, 108 yards and a receiving touchdown, even had a rushing touchdown on the first drive as well.
He did. Again, we had a great game plan to get Dallas the ball in certain situations and other guys the ball in other situations, and Dallas responded. You know, after the first series, I said, Dallas looks tired. And Coach X says, well, he's had 4 receptions already in the game, so he rose up, made some big plays.
Jake Winicky, 6 catches, 164 yards, and 2 touchdowns. He's almost being forgotten about at times, including by the SIU defense, wide open in the end zone on one of those.
He was a good scramble by Tyrann on that play, and made some tough catches. He had a big catch at the end of the game, towards the end of the game, to set up a field goal. Let's not forget some of those young guys. I mean, Adam and Marquise had better games than they've had, and then Alex Wilde gets called into action, goes in there and catches a huge touchdown in the game. We talked about that during pregame, that you never know when you're gonna affect the game. He was ready.
Other point too, your yards per carry, while the total yards aren't there in the rushing game, the yards per carry, Mengarelli and also Wallace putting together, you're very happy with.
I am. I thought we ran the ball really well, and we're not a team with the way we're designed and the type of weapons we have that we're going to just bash the ball in there. But when we were called to run the ball, our guys did a good job, and I'm happy with that. I think our O-line is doing a very good job.
I want to hit on your special teams and a very important portion of this game. Southern Illinois entered that contest leading the nation in kickoff return yardage at 30 yards per return. You held them to 22 per return. Sam Coob and some of those pooch kicks, an excellent job in coverage when you did kick deep. That was a heck of a job by your unit.
Well, again, Jimmy Rogers heads that up, and we kind of knew where they were returning the ball based on their scheme, and they're good at it because they master it. Guys do the same thing over and over, and there was a point there we said, let's kick the lob or the pooch, and it really paid off. I mean, we lobbed it to the 19, and they were fair catching it, so that's tremendous.
2 defensive players I want to make note of. Christian Roseboom, middle linebacker, your redshirt freshman, had 20 tackles he was credited for on Saturday all over the field.
All over the field, literally, because they didn't run between the tackles but 8 times in the football game. So their game plan was to spread it out, get it to their athletes. So Christian was making tackles outside the numbers many times. He spent himself. He really did a great job of getting sideline to sideline.
How nice was it to see Kellen Solik have such a big game? 7 tackles, he had a pair of sacks, blocked a field goal as well, a breakout game for him, and this is junior year.
Yeah, he had a great game, a little disappointed in his celebration after his first sack, but he learned from that. But bottom line is, if we contain the quarterback when we should contain him, he gets another 2 sacks in that football game. So again, it's a team effort on defense.
3 teams are 2-0 in the Missouri Valley Football Conference right now. You're one of them. Another one is North Dakota State. So there's that. There's the Dakota marker. It's all on the line Saturday afternoon when you renew that rivalry in Fargo.
Well, that's a fun game. It's an intense environment. We look forward to going up there and competing. We need to watch this film and get these things corrected tomorrow, and then we'll go back to work.
Jacks are in Fargo to take on North Dakota State 2:30 Saturday afternoon. Our coverage starts at 1:30 throughout the Jackrabbit Sports Network. Let's have a look at this week's Jackrabbit legend.
A player, assistant, and head coach. He's perhaps the most beloved figure in South Dakota State football history. This week's Jackrabbit legend is Wayne Hensel, presented by Legend Seeds. Hensel was a standout both on the gridiron and in the classroom as a student athlete at State. From 1955 to 57, Hensel was a starting lineman for the Jacks. He earned Scholastic All-American honors in 1956 and was team captain in all North Central Conference on the 57 squad that won the league outright. He was drafted by the National Football League's New York Giants, but an injury ended his career before it started. So Hensel entered into the coaching ranks, where he spent 14 years at the high school level. He was selected as the inaugural Ralph Ginn Award winner for coaching excellence, named in honor of the man he played for at SDSU. Hensel returned to his alma mater as an assistant on John Gregory's staff in 1973, and in 1982 became the head coach of the Jackrabbit football program. He recruited and coached some of the best players in program history during his tenure as head coach. Quarterbacks Mike Bush and Ted Wall, running backs Dan Sonic and Rick Wager, wideout Jeff Tiefenthaler, tight end Dennis Thomas, and nose guard Kevin Tetzloff, among a group that led Hensel to 45 wins and two runner-up finishes in the North Central Conference. Hensel retired after the 1990 season and remained in Brookings until his untimely death in November of 2012 at the age of 76. He may be gone, but anyone who met him will never forget the man lovingly referred to as Hawkeye. Wayne Hensel, a Jackrabbit legend.
This Jackrabbit legend is presented by Legend Seeds, your regional seed leader.
Being part of a great team means you know your role and you work your role to the best of your ability. If you're consistently going to show up and be your best, you're going to be part of that team. You can see the success they have over time. It's not just 1 year flash in the pan. It's consistent success over time, which makes them great. And that's where the work ethic comes in. The ability to come into work, do the same thing repeatedly, day after day after day, and putting your best foot forward is going to separate you from the rest.
Choose the experts. Choose Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine.
Get ready for the Hefties Fan PhD Tip of the Week, encouraging you to get up, get loud, and get involved, and give the Jackrabbits a hometown advantage.
This year was fantastic. I got my best yields ever.
Record yields start by putting the best seed in the ground. At Hefty, we not only pick the best genetics and traits for you, but we have the most stringent seed grower specs in the industry. That means higher yields for you.
We're Hefties, and we're big on the farm.
Hefty brand soybeans, agronomy, answers, yield.
Hey, JX fans, you know, I know, the student section is important in our whole environment. So when they're doing a chant, feel free to get involved. Be part of that whole environment and help intimidate the opponent.
This week's fan tip was brought to you by Hefty's Fan PhD, helping Jackrabbit fans go from good to great. Before we get back to this week's show, here's a look at next week's Insider.
The Jackrabbit Insider continues with this week's Senior Student Athlete Spotlight on a young man who is a father, will soon be a husband, and made SportsCenter last Saturday. Here is a closer look at Connor Landberg.
From Laguna Hills, California, the weather is obviously a little different out there. The climate, when it comes to wintertime, is it's interesting for me, but I've grown to love it here. I love the atmosphere at SDSU. I just fell in love with the place.
When you watched him on film, he made plays. You know, he was consistent. He didn't have this huge highlight reel, but he made play after play after play. And as we got to know him, we knew he was an even keel guy, that when he walked out on the field, he wasn't going to have these highs and lows. He was just going to go do his job.
Landberg admits he learned a ton from one of the best receivers to ever play at State, Jason Schneider.
I think it was great that I was behind him, because he taught me a lot, and he made me grow up as a player. I looked up to him more of as a role model and stuff, and now with Goddard and Winicky there, we just have weapons.
Landberg is a weapon as well. He proved that 2 years ago in SDSU's opening round playoff victory at Montana State. He made two catches, one for a touchdown, and secured an onside kick to seal the win.
I remember that it was about negative 20 degrees, snow was everywhere, and I was just like, what am I doing here? But then we came out firing. We had a couple big plays in the game. I scored a touchdown at the end, fumble recovery on an onside kick, and the rest is history. I mean, it was great. It was a great win.
And he earned a SportsCenter top play honor last weekend, making this sensational one-handed touchdown catch in the 52-14 win over Western Illinois.
I saw the read, ran a vertical route, and Taren threw it up. And I kind of jumped, put my arm up. It kind of stuck, fell in. And then I looked over to the official. He was signaling no catch. All of a sudden, we saw the replay on the screen, and everyone, the crowd erupted, and everyone ran onto the field, calling it for a timeout. But yeah, it was just an awesome moment, finally when they signaled touchdown. But yeah, it was a great moment.
But there is so much more to life than just football. Landberg is living proof of that. He's the father of a beautiful little girl named Layton.
She's 15 months now. It's great because my family, they come out for the football games, but they also come out just to see Layton. And when they get there to my house or whatever, they don't give me a hug anymore. They go straight to Layton, and they just spend every moment with her, but it's awesome. And they're in love. It's awesome.
Layton's parents, Connor and Michaela, are engaged to be married next year, and becoming a family man has matured the senior from California.
I think it's made me really grow up as a person. I think that football is a sport where you need to grow up, and SDSU gave me the opportunity with the coaches and everything. The coaches really instill in you that you need to make a difference in everything that you do.
Well, you know, I'm proud of Connor. You know, he's being part of his daughter's life. He's supporting her. He's helping raise her. And yes, it matures him. But again, it's a picture for some of our other players to say, here's a guy that's got a lot on his plate, and he's succeeding at a high level.
When the Insider returns, a look at some of the tremendous catches the receiving corps has made this season after a great run from 1982.
Farmers are paying more attention to water quality and making it a priority.
Every farm is different. And every farmer is different, but everyone wants to do what's right for the environment. We're conserving the water, the limited water that we do get, and we're not wasting it.
The individual farmer has to be proactive.
No-till allows our crops to use all the water that we are blessed to receive.
We keep water clean.
For the people of South Dakota, it's about doing the right thing.
I am Al Miron.
Steve Halverson.
Jeff Lockner.
This is Farming.
Listen up. This is the time, this is the place. And this is Ford F-150, the truck that goes toe-to-toe with your life. Made of high-strength, military-grade aluminum alloy, it pulled the highest safety rating the government can give. And with Pro Trailer Backup Assist, it's like having your head on a swivel, pal. So load up your crew. This is the time.
Now get up to $10,395 in total savings or lease an F-150 for just $279 a month. Visit your local Northland Ford dealer today.
JackRabbit Insider is brought to you by the Hefty Seed Company, Agronomy, Answers, Yield. Your local Northland Ford dealers. Visit northlandford.com or your local dealer. Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine. Expert care when you need it. The University Bookstore. Shop now at jackrabbitcentral.com. South Dakota Corn. This is Farming. Proud sponsor of the South Dakota Showdown Series. And by South Dakota State University. Be great. Start here.
The Insider continues with a look at some of the tremendous catches we have seen through the first four games of the football season from Messrs. Winicky, Goddard, and Landberg.
Christian receives the letter high snap, a fake to Mangarelli. He'll chuck it deep right side for Jake Winicky, and he makes the catch, diving in the end zone, touchdown South Dakota State.
As impressive of a play as any this year was the third down catch, because of where the ball was located and where he was with the man to accelerate past the guy, but yet have to almost go back and catch the football was very amazing. It wasn't a one-hander, but it was very, very amazing.
Christian, an empty set from his own 39. He has time. He goes deep into double coverage. Winicky jumped up, and he caught it amid two bodies.
Basically about a 12-inch window to go up and pull the ball down in. He expects to make every one of those catches, which is, I think a lot of these plays that have been made recently is confidence and belief.
Luan takes the shotgun snap, looks right, looks left, airs it up, back left corner of the end zone, jumping Jake Winicky. Did the Wizard do it again? Of course he did. The most touchdowns by a receiver in SDSU history.
When you got between 9.5 and 10-inch hands between he and Dallas, I mean, that... That doesn't hurt, you know, when you have some big mitts.
Mangarelli lined up as a wideout. He's in motion. Fake to Wallace. They fake the option. Throw back to Goddard left side. He makes the catch inside the five, and he's into the end zone.
His skill set is very special for his position. His hand-eye coordination is phenomenal.
Jack's no huddle. Christian, a play fake, goes down the middle. Goddard makes the catch, bounces off a tackle. He's inside the 10, and he's ran down to the 7-yard line.
Big hands once again, and is able to make, you know, amazing catches and do those things. Tracks the ball extremely well.
Two backs alongside Christian. He'll air it up right side for Goddard. Leaping one-hand grab. Get out of here. Touchdown, Dallas Goddard.
Oh, my. What a grab by Dallas Goddard. They just ran the fade right to the back corner of the end zone.
The amazing touchdown catch this past weekend.
The Jackrabbit offense has scored on 5 straight possessions. Christian, a play fake, looking deep. He'll throw it up down the near side for Goddard. Tipped the ball up to himself. Made the catch. Ran through a tackle. He's inside the 10, and he's into the end zone. Touchdown, South Dakota State.
Wow.
That was unbelievable.
He's getting held off the line of scrimmage. He can't even run the route he's supposed to run. But he doesn't give up on the play. He keeps going, and it's still one-on-one coverage. So you put the ball up to him, and it's kind of bouncing around. But, there's something. Some guys are just going to give up when they're getting held. Give up and or maybe not go as hard. And that's just not part of his makeup.
Christian takes the low snap, looks left. He'll throw that way for Connor Lambert. Leaping one-hand grab. Can somebody catch a ball with two hands on this team?
Why? Why use two when you only need one?
Connor made the joke. It was nice that Taryn threw me the football. But once again, you know, run the route like you're going to get the ball, which is what he did. And then when the ball came, you know, he made the play that needed to be made. So really just super excited for him and the way he has really progressed this year.
And the Jackrabbit football team hoping there's plenty more highlights this Saturday when the Dakota Marker is on the line in Fargo against rival North Dakota State. Kickoff just after 2:30 Central Time. Our radio coverage begins at 1:30 throughout the Jackrabbit Sports Network. We'll have highlights of that game next week, a look at the SDSU women's basketball team, and much more. So for all of us here inside our Yeager Media Center studios, I'm Tyler Merriam, and we'll see you next time on the Jackrabbit Insider.